Right now in New York, Jill Sarin, who is a cast member of The Real Housewives of New York City and author of the book Secrets of a Jewish Mother. Right now in Hollywood, Wendy Walsh, who is a TV journalist and doctor of psychology. Jill, Wendy,
hi.
Let's begin with our Showbiz Tonight exclusive poll. Here is the question. Sandra Bullock and Jesse James, should they reconcile for the sake of the kids? Only 6% said yes, a whopping 94% said no. The people have spoken. Barely anybody thinks they should reconcile for the sake of the kids. Jill, well, are you surprised?
I'm a little surprised how weighted it is. But honestly, I mean, what kids? She doesn't have children with him. They're his kids. And now she's adopted a baby on her own. You know, the smell test with how long she was waiting for this baby, it really doesn't pass the smell test. I can't believe she was waiting for 4 years. But it's her baby. I mean, so I don't think that there are kids involved in this. And quite frankly, he crossed the line and there's no place to go right now. They have to get
the adoption process does take a long time in many cases. Wendy, what do you think? Do you think people overwhelmingly voted against Sandra and Jesse's reconciliation because they're just so darn protective of Sandra?
Let me tell you this, Brooke. I am shocked that so many selfish adult Americans don't think children are a perfectly good reason to learn some relationship tools, to learn how to forgive and build some intimacy and get back together. The fact that, what's this, individual rights and freedom to be selfish and find a new partner and then screw that up too? Imagine the life that this baby's going to have. Now he's potentially going to have a stepmother to deal with, a divorced dad.
Yeah,
his kids have been
I understand.
Baby.
It could be really, really difficult to establish full trust again. I understand. You know, yeah. Virtually impossible in
but
some cases.
But better to be in a relationship
and
with
ladies,
his mom.
I do want to tell you right now about one TV show that I'll bet you Sandra Bullock has no interest in watching. It features celebrity mistresses looking for love on a new reality show. You heard right. There is a new show in the works that will help infamous mistresses, including one of Tiger's alleged mistresses, find true love. The show is hosted by Michelle Harris, and this afternoon I spoke exclusively with her for the interview you will see only on Showbiz Tonight, and I had to ask, are you serious? Watch. What do you say to those critics who feel that a show like this would be glorifying mistresses, celebrating women who've destroyed a marriage, destroyed a home?
Well, first of all, we have the wives on too, so it's not just the mistresses. And I don't really think the mistresses have destroyed a home. They've been lied to. Again, we're blaming the women when we should be blaming these men. You know, in certain cases, you know, you can't speak for all of them, but that's what's happening. And most of the women watching the show right now, I bet they've been hit on by a married guy. I certainly have. Even married celebrities have hit on me. And the things that they say, oh, we're getting a divorce. Oh, it's just for PR. We're not human lie detectors. So I think everyone deserves a second chance. I think let's give these ladies a second chance.
And Jamie Grubbs, one of Tiger Woods' alleged mistresses, is reportedly signed on to participate.
Right.
So I know that you run into a lot of people in your travels, Michelle. If you did run into Elin Woods, what would you say to her about this show?
Well, I mean, coming from a wife perspective, obviously they're seeing it a different way, but because we are helping the wives too, hopefully she would like it.
Really?
Yes, because we're helping the other wives that have been lied to. Both women have been lied to.
If you're Elin Woods sitting at home and you see a woman that you feel has essentially destroyed your family, your home, how could you like
no,
this
Tiger,
show?
No, Tiger did that, and you're right.
I think the play goes both ways, though.
No,
She participated.
She participated, but how knowingly?
But do you believe these mistresses in everything that they're telling you? Oh, I was completely lied to. You know, in a way, I'm a little bit skeptical. I think they had to know.
I don't necessarily know that. I don't necessarily know that because you can't ever know what someone's marriage is like. There are people who are married for different reasons and have different relationships where they do go outside the marriage. So how are you supposed to know that?
Jill, very, very quickly, do you agree with Michelle there that the mistresses are the victims?
No, they're definitely not the victims, and I hope the show doesn't get picked up. Just because she's creating it doesn't mean it's going to be on the air, and I have no interest in watching mistresses trying to date. I just don't. I don't know why they're famous. I think it's terrible, and I certainly, if I were one of them, wouldn't want my children one day to see this. But that's how my reputation's built on it.
The host does insist that the show would have redeeming qualities, but I'll have to see that to believe it. Jill Sarin and Wendy Walsh, thanks, ladies.